Go ahead and turn your packet to page 37. Pause the video and copy down the parallel lines and perpendicular lines definition. And then go ahead and find the slope of each line below. Again, pause the video as you calculate it before you see the answers. Here are the answers below. If you notice, line A has a slope of 1. Line B also has a slope of 1. Because they're the same slope, you're going to be able to say that these two are parallel to each other, right? If they have the same slope, think about it. On the graph, they're never going to cross. However, line C is a negative 1. That's the opposite reciprocal compared to the other slope. So what we can say is that lines A and B are parallel. You can use this notation where it's like A and then the two slanted lines for parallel, B. And then once I give you the next set of definitions or the notes, you'll be able to see that lines A and B are perpendicular to line C. So perpendicular, the notation for it is kind of an upside down T. This will make more sense as we practice. So go ahead and copy down these notes because this is what's going to give you the indication of what makes it a parallel line or what makes them perpendicular lines, right? And key is opposite and reciprocal. It has to be both. It can't just be, oh, this was a 2, now it's a negative 2. No, that doesn't count, right? It actually has to be opposite and reciprocal. Pause the video here so that you can copy down the notes. Let's try the next one. Solve for the slope. If you notice, this is not in slope-intercept form. We need to get it into slope-intercept form, otherwise we can't tell what the slope is. So let's go ahead and add x. You get 3y equals x plus 1, and then we're going to divide everything by 3. So I get y equals 1/3 x plus 1/3. Now, my slope on this, I can identify it, and it's going to be 1/3. So I'm gonna write it at the bottom. I'm just in the habit of writing m equals 1/3, right? That gives me the information I'll need later on to determine if any are parallel or perpendicular. Line B, well, I actually don't have to do anything. My slope is right here, m equals negative 3. And then line C. We do have to rearrange this. I have to get it into slope-intercept form in order for me to get the final slope. So I'm going to divide by negative 6 now and make sure I simplify completely. Y equals 1/3 x minus 2/3. So my slope here is 1/3. Now take a look at all three of these slopes here. Off the bat, I can tell you that A and C are parallel because they're the same exact slope. So I can say that lines A and C are parallel. Or I could even write A is parallel to C. Then below that, are any of them perpendicular? Well, I know these two. Oop, let's keep it in the same color. I know these two are parallel. Okay. Perpendicular means opposite reciprocal. If I take the opposite of 1/3, I get negative 1/3. If I take the reciprocal, I get negative 3. Hey, this one was a negative 3. So that means A and C are perpendicular to B. So these answers would be my final answers, parallel and then perpendicular. Sometimes they might not be parallel or perpendicular, right? But that's the goal. That's what you're trying to figure out, if they are parallel or perpendicular. So go ahead and practice on the bottom. I'm gonna move on to the next part of the lesson. You can determine, like, if I give you a point and a slope, or point and an equation, well, and I want you to write a parallel equation, that means it needs to be the same slope. So this slope right now is negative 1. So the parallel slope is going to be negative 1. So now I have my slope and my point. What do I have? I have a point and a slope, so I can put it in point slope. So I get y minus 4 equals negative 1 times x plus 2, right? Put it into point slope format. Go ahead and rewrite this in slope intercept form by distributing, by adding. Guess what? Oops, sorry. This is a mistake. This should be a 2, and then this should be a 2. So this is my parallel equation to the original problem. You can do this for perpendicular as well, but what you have to do is identify that the slope is 4. So the perpendicular slope you're going to use is negative 1, 4. Put this in slope-intercept form. Once you put this in slope-intercept form, you're going to distribute negative 1 fourth x plus 1, and you're going to subtract. So you get y equals negative 1 fourth x minus 1. Here is your final equation. So go ahead and practice on this page. Determine how to write in point slope, get it in point slope form, then change the slope intercept form so that you are writing equation in slope intercept form through the given points to get a parallel line, or write it in slope intercept form to get a perpendicular line. And then other times, if I ask you, determine if these lines are parallel, perpendicular, neither. Sometimes they might not have anything in common, and that's okay.